Laceration care. A laceration means a cut anywhere on your body. It's caused by something sharp like a knife or a razor. If the cut is shallow, just on the surface of your skin, that isn't very serious. But if it's deep and even goes into the muscle, that is serious, and then it has to be closed. You can't just cover up a laceration. First, it must be cleaned the right way, then it can be stitched or bandaged, or the two sides of the cut can be glued together. There are reasons why the laceration should be fixed in different ways. For example, if you have a cut on your arm and you apply pressure for 15 minutes and it's still bleeding badly, that's serious. If you have a cut and you can see inside to the muscle tissue or bone or fat or the tendon, which connects the muscle to the bone, that is a deep and serious cut. If the laceration is on your elbow or your fingers, these are more difficult places to heal because you move them a lot. Stitches are the best way to mend those areas. Also, if the lacerated area is dirty, it has to be carefully fixed. If the cut is jagged and not a straight line, it has to be stitched to heal. When a doctor mends the laceration by stitching or gluing, it will heal better and will have less opportunity for infection to begin. You'll have less pain and there'll be a less noticeable scar. The doctor will examine the cut and decide if it can be left to heal by itself or if it needs more care. If it's deep and serious, the doctor may consult a surgeon to repair it for you. First, a special soap will be used to clean the area well. Then, you might get a shot so the area is numb and so you don't feel any pain. Then it will be examined to make sure there's no dirt, glass, metal, or wood embedded in the area. And if there is, it will be removed. There are a few ways the cut can be mended: a special glue, tape that is made for skin mending, stitches, or staples. If the doctor decides that glue is the best way, it will be applied 3 times, 1 minute apart, for the glue to set. If it's serious, you might get stitches after the glue. The glue is left on for 7 to 10 days, and then it falls off on its own. You don't have to cover it up after that time. The special tape that works with skin pulls both sides of the cut together to heal. You might get bandages wrapped around the taped cut too, depending on what the doctor decides is the best treatment. The tape will fall off on its own after 5 to 10 days. If the doctor decides you need stitches, a special type of paper will cover the cut area to keep it clean and safe. If the cut is very deep, you might need to have stitches on the inside layer of the cut, as well as the outer layer of your skin. The stitches inside don't have to be removed. Later, your body will absorb them. You'll have to go back to the doctor 5 to 10 days later for the stitches on the top of your skin to be removed. You'll have antibiotic ointment applied to the cut to help prevent infection. If your cut needs staples, you will also get antibiotic ointment applied on top of it to help prevent infection. The doctor may decide to bandage the wound on top of the staples too. The staples don't come out by themselves, so you have to go to the doctor again 5 to 10 days later to have them removed. Once you get home, if you got stitches or staples, you need to check often to make sure the wound isn't wet or dirty. If the doctor bandaged your cut, you have to change it every day and put on a new one, and change it if it becomes wet or dirty. For the first day, it can't become wet at all. But after that, you can take a shower or bath, but don't let the cut be soaked underwater at all. After the stitches or staples have been removed, you can go back to your regular shower or bath routine. Every day you need to make sure the wound is clean and follow the instructions for how often you need to clean it. Clean it with soap and water, but make sure that the soap is completely rinsed off. And carefully pat the wound dry. Don't rub it hard. After you've cleaned it, apply the antibiotic to the surface. This does two things. It prevents infection, and it also keeps bandages from sticking to the surface so it doesn't pull and hurt you when you remove the bandages. Remember, some stitches and all staples require that you go back to the doctor to remove them. If you got tape to fix your laceration, remember to check and make sure it's staying clean and dry. If the doctor put bandages on too, change them every day and keep it clean. Remember that even a smaller cut needs to be dried after taking a shower or bath. You can use a towel to gently pat it dry. It's really important not to rub the cut dry. Please carefully pat it instead. If it gets a little bit wet, don't worry. Just pat it with the towel. Remember, if you got tape, it will fall off by itself. You may be tempted to peel it off, but don't bother. It comes off on its own. Now, if you got glue to mend the wound, keep it clean and dry. Taking a shower or bath is fine. Just don't allow the cut to be wet for a long time by going swimming or leaving it in bath water. Don't rub the glued area to dry it, just pat it dry. Don't do any heavy exercise that causes you to sweat because the sweat will cause the glue to fall off too fast. If you got glue, you will not have antibiotic ointment to put on top of it because that would not work with the medicine already in the glue. That would cause the glue to soften, and then the cut can't heal the right way. If the doctor decided to bandage on top of the glue, then change the bandage every day and keep it clean. The glue will come off from 5 to 10 days later. Please don't be tempted to peel it off yourself earlier. It's important to remember this information for all of the different ways the doctor treated your cut. If the doctor gave you medicine to take, follow the directions carefully. Also, if the doctor gave you medicine to put on the wound, follow the directions carefully. If you want to make sure that you don't get a bad scar, when the stitches or staples have been removed or the glue and the tape have fallen off, use sunblock on the healed area to reduce scarring. Check the sunscreen bottle to make sure it's at least 30 SPF and ignore the temptation to pick or scratch at the cut. Let it heal. It's really important to follow the doctor's instructions. If the doctor said you should make an appointment a certain number of days later, you need to make sure that you do go. If the cut is looking good, that's great. But if you notice signs of infection, if it seems very red, swollen, or is painful, or if you change the bandages and there's a lot of blood or yellow or white liquid, you need to tell your doctor about it. It helps to keep the area of your body that has the injury, your arm or your leg, elevated to promote healing. There are a few reasons you should see your primary care doctor when you've had a laceration. If you went to the hospital for your laceration and the doctor gave you a tetanus shot or a shot to make you numb, and later you notice swelling, pain, or redness, you need to go see the doctor. If you get a fever or you notice that the cut is reopening, you should go to the doctor. When you change your bandages, if you notice a smell that doesn't seem right, you should see the doctor. If you notice dirt, glass, or other materials are starting to come out of the wound, you need to go to the doctor. If you take pain medication but it doesn't seem to work, see the doctor. If the laceration is still red and doesn't seem to be improving, see your doctor. If it's still bleeding or seems wet with yellow liquid, see the doctor. Go to the doctor for any of those reasons. Return to the ER. For these reasons, if the laceration is significantly more swollen and getting worse, if pain medication is not helping take away the pain, and it's getting worse, if a strange lump appears on the laceration, if you notice new redness on or near the laceration, if the cut is on your hand or foot, and you notice you can't use your fingers or your foot very well, or if your fingers or toes change color, for example, if they turn blue, for any of the reasons I just mentioned, you must go back to the ER.